Through Christ, let us offer our sacrifice of praise. Let our lips proclaim his praise. Jesus said to Peter, "Feed my lambs, tend my sheep, and feed my sheep." Blessed be God.
Blessed be God, reign forever. Amen.
In sorrow for her sins, and with faith in his mercy, let us turn to the Lord, for with him there is mercy and plenteous redemption.
Thank you.
has through many generations and by many generous servants has blessed this college to be a house of faith and fruitful study. Grant us in the same way so to learn truth as to bear its light along all our ways and to learn Christ as always to be in it, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Kindly be seated for the readings.
The first reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 61, reading from verses 1 to 3. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor, and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praises instead of a faint spirit. This is the word of the God.
And to still another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are the work of one and the same Spirit, and He distributes them to each one just as He determines. This is the word of the Lord.
Lord, my shepherd, I know.
a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends. For everything that I have learned from my father, I have made you known to you. You did so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command, love each other. Kitu samidunge subhasna mese.
Speak in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated. You did not choose me. It was I who chose you and sent you to go and bear much fruit. Fruit that will last, and everything you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. These were the words of Jesus our Lord to his disciples then. And Father Nihal, these are the words of your Lord to you on this day of your induction and installation as the headmaster of St. Thomas's Preparatory School, Kulupitiya. Let me, at the very outset, thank you for inviting me to preach at this service. And let me, on behalf of all those who are assembled here, congratulate you on your appointment as headmaster. And we wish you and you, Chinta, and the boys God's richest and choicest blessings as you journey through, and ask for God's divine wisdom that you would need to take this institution to greater heights. Father Nihal, administering a school of this nature in Colombo is not easy. You have done well as headmaster at St. Thomas. Can be much different from what you accomplished there in the hill country. A school of this nature, for that matter, is a school that will bring its own package of problems. We live in the cosmopolitan city. We live among parents who are struck by the ill effects of the pandemic. Children are mentally, physically, spiritually, and emotionally being challenged. And in that context, God is calling you to come here and to bear fruit, fruit that will last. And you need to ask many gifts from God. You need to ask many things from God. Ask the Father in my name, the Lord Jesus said, and he will give you. And you will need to ask him with confidence and faith. And I believe the Lord will impart that which is necessary for you to administer this institution
and also wisdom to resolve
all the challenges that you may be faced with.
And so at the beginning of your apostolate here, Headmaster,
the call from the Lord is to remain in his love.
If you are to bear much fruit, as students, as teachers, as parents, as well-wishers, and above all, as a school community.
After having explained the mystery of our oneness with him, our Lord Jesus reminds us of his new commandment of love. If we first realize our oneness with Christ, the vine, we will acquire the ability to love one another. It is with that love that you need to face those challenges. It is with that love that you need to resolve the conflicts that you may be called to put right or address. And that love will fill your heart and the hearts of all your children and parents and the school community to move on in the right direction. He has given us a new commandment of love. In all that we are called to do. Father Nihal, I want you to reflect on three quick points that I want to share with you this morning. Firstly, know that God has endowed you with many spiritual gifts, skills, in order to handle this task that he's giving unto you. 1 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 7 says that a spiritual gift is given to each of us when we as branches abide in him who is the vine. And Jesus says, without me, you can do nothing. We want to be doubly sure that we are doing the right thing and that we are successful in the role that God has placed us and to accomplish that which he has called us to accomplish. So remember, you are not coming here with your own strength, with your own skills and expertise. It is the Lord who has endowed you with many skills, and it is because he believes that you have the ability to lead this great institution, he has called you. And if he has called you, he will give you the resources needed. Secondly, know what it means to be successful. Know what it means to be successful. One of the great benefits of finding and fulfilling your life's calling is that it settles the question of what constitutes true success. Father Nihal, many will be watching you. The CCTV cameras are placed on you. The way you walk, the way you speak, the way you act, the way you deal with situations that come your way. To know whether you are successful, whether you are doing the right thing, and whether you are satisfying their appointment. Many of us have a faulty definition of success. We have been brought into the idea that success is measured by how well others or even our predecessors have done. Remember, that would be a recipe for utter frustration. No matter what you do, remember, someone else will always do it better. But when you define success in terms of God's calling and in terms of God's purposes for your life and for the institution that you serve, the standard changes completely. Father Nihal, true success is not what you have done compared to what others have done. Remember that always. But true success is what you have done compared to what God has assigned you to do, even as you discern His will and His purpose in the here and now. Remember this, a spiritual gift in exercising leadership is given to each of us as a means of helping to establish God's reign in all what we do. Jesus said he was successful because he was able to accomplish the work of his Father. Accomplish the work his father sent him to do. Paul was able to say at the end of his life journey, I have run my race, I have kept my faith, and I have done my part. Thirdly, know the necessity and urgency to keep on developing your relationship with the vine and to sharpen his skills, gifts, and talents in you in order for you to serve your people better. David didn't suddenly become an expert marksman with a slingshot in his hand when Goliath showed up. David did not become a master harpist when King Saul invited him to the palace. David took the long, slow, disciplined route. David had no idea what his future held. He simply found joy and fulfillment in discerning God's will for his life and developing his God-given gifts in him. Father Nihal, you did well, as I said earlier, in your appointment at St. Thomas's Gurutalava, learning from those experiences, from all that you consider to be successful and to be a failure, God has called you to do even better here in this place where He's placing you. The greatest obstacle to anyone's personal growth isn't ignorance. It is the illusion of knowledge. I repeat, it is the illusion of knowledge. And attitude of I know it all. Nobody need to correct me. There's nothing that I need to learn any further. When you believe in your heart that you know it all and that you need not correct yourself at any time, and that you have come to the zenith of your performance, alas, for from that moment you stop growing. And from that moment you begin to slip down the precipice, which means you are done. Which zone would you like to live in? As a leader that God has placed you in here, would you like to be in the challenge zone, saying, I would like to attempt to do what I haven't done before? Or would you like to be in the comfort zone, which says, I only do what I already know I can do? Or would you like to be in the coasting zone, which says, I don't even do what I have done before? Philip Brooks says, open quote, sad is the day for any man when he becomes absolutely satisfied with the life he is living, the thoughts he is thinking, and the things he is doing. When there ceases to be forever beating at the doors of his soul a desire to do something larger, which seeks and knows he was meant and intend to do. Sad is the day for any man when he becomes absolutely satisfied with the life he is living, the thoughts he is thinking, and the things he is doing. When there ceases to be forever beating at the doors of his soul a desire to do something larger, which he seeks and knows he was meant and intended to do. Father Nihal, David's brothers knew David and their brother's skills. Yet, none of them told King Saul about him. In life, do not expect others to speak about your performance. But God will bring realization in the hearts of those with whom you are working. When you lead a life of righteousness, when you lead a life of justice, and to see that the purposes of God is achieved through everyone who journey on with you. The Bible says only one of the servants answered. He went and told the king, Saul, I have seen a son of Jesse of Bethlehem who knows how to play the harp. He is a brave man and a warrior. He speaks well and is a fine-looking man. And the Lord is with him. It is that spark of divine presence that your teachers, your students, your parents, and those who administer you need to see in your life and give thanks to God. David didn't compete with his brothers or complain about his status as a sheep herder. David just kept developing his relationship with God and sharpening his God-given talents and skills. And when the time was right, God glorified him. Father Nihal, just keep on doing it, and you will be successful in the sight of God. Amen.
Kindly stand for the affirmation of faith. Let us declare our faith in God. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us pray. As we give thanks to God for this school and for its new headmaster, we offer our thanks and our prayers. We thank you for William Thomas Keeble, the founder of the two prep schools here and at Bandaravela, for the importance he gave to primary education and the nurturing of the child at every age. Give us the energy that we need to engage in the learning experience of children of all ages. We thank you for his interest in history and the lives of people. Give us a thirst, O God, to read and to ponder in our hearts the stories of our people and our nation. Lord, in your mercy, we thank you for Norman G. Abenaker, who took on the mantle of this school amidst war. Give us, O God, the sense of commitment that he had to steer our lives in the midst of great adversity, being prepared at all times so that we never give up. Lord, in your mercy, we thank you for J.T.R. Perumbanaiyagam, who built upon the labors of those who had given of their best, and for the buildings that he built in order to expand the school. Give us, O God, a vision and the enthusiasm to move beyond what we see, so that our labors will enrich the lives of those entrusted to our care, so that true learning may abound. Lord, in your mercy, we thank you for John Shelton Leslie Fernando, who dedicated his entire life teaching in this school. Give us, O God, a sense of dedication so that we may provide continuity in the midst of meaningful change. Lord, in your mercy, we thank you for the labors of N. Johessen Kasichetti, who knew every child and teacher by name. Give us, O God, the ability to recognize in one another the diversity that we bring to the communities in which we live. Help us to see that our lives are meant to bring joy and happiness to others. Lord, in your mercy, we thank you for Bishop Dushanta Rodrigo, who committed himself wholeheartedly to provide the entire prep school community, from its students to its staff members, to all boys and to parents, with so many opportunities through the numerous activities that he both initiated and completely supported. His love for the field of arts will always be remembered as the many concerts and fairs that were carried out during his tenure set high standards for the years to come. We earnestly pray for our outgoing headmaster as he takes on the mantle of providing leadership to our diocese as the Bishop of Colombo. Lord, in your mercy, we thank you, O God, that you are our pilgrim God, who has journeyed with us through time. Help us never to live for self, but for others, keeping the victory of our faith while scattering light around us, being ourselves forever as you, Lord, remain the shepherd that leads us to new pastures of learning. Lord, in your mercy.
In the name of God, we now intend to institute and install our well-beloved in Christ, Nihal Jude Ranjit Fernando, who has been called and duly appointed sixth headmaster of this school. And for as much as the care of children, their nurture and education is so sacred a responsibility, we pray earnestly that God will grant to his servant, Father Nihal, grace to discharge aright the duties which belong to so sacred a trust. Father Nihal, you have been duly chosen and appointed the headmaster of this school. Do you believe that it is God who has called you to this service?
I believe so.
Will you seek by the grace of God to fulfill this sacred work committed to you with faithfulness and diligence, ever seeking to love our Lord with your whole heart and to witness to him in word and deed?
I will so do, the Lord being my helper.
Will you watch over this school with faith, hope, love, humility, and courage, in conformity with the spirit of the vision of its founder, its tradition, honoring its constitution and furthering its ideals?
I will do so, the Lord being my helper.
Integration,
I will so do, the Lord being my helper. I will so do, the Lord being my helper.
Will you strive to understand the hearts, minds, and identities of the children in your care and to guide them that they may all experience the love of God and be nurtured into integrated persons?
I will so do, the Lord being my helper.
Community, please respond by saying loud, "We will," to the next question. If you want a cup of tea after service. Will you, the community of St. Thomas's Preparatory School,
we pray, gracious God, the gift of your grace to your servant, Father Nihal, chosen to be headmaster of this school, grant that he may well and fitly discharge his task, and of your great goodness may be well pleasing to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We, Dushanta Rodrigo, by divine permission, 16th Bishop of the Diocese of Colombo and visitor to this school, on behalf of the Church of Ceylon and of the Board of Governors of this school, do hereby institute and commission you, Nihal Jude Ranjit Fernando, as headmaster of this school of St. Thomas's at Collupitia, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. My dear Nihal, Chinta, Eran, Nevan, may the blessing of our pilgrim God, the Creator, Liberator, and Comforter, rest upon you and upon your labors undertaken in his name. The Lord give you grace, courage, wisdom, strength, and love to grow in his will, now and forever. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as it is in heaven. Give us today our bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
people of the community of St. Thomas's Preparatory School, Kolupitiya. Can you stand, please? You have a new headmaster, the Reverend Nihal Fernando. Receive him with love, respect, and kindness. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, whom in your tender mercy gave your only Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made a full atonement for the sins of the whole world, offering once for all his one sacrifice of himself, he instituted and in his holy gospel commanded us to continue a perpetual memory of his precious death until he comes again. Hear us, merciful Father, we humbly pray, and grant that we, receiving these gifts of your creation, this bread and this wine, according to your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, of the power of the Holy Spirit. Our Siluel, Padipattu Maripattat Kaha, Kartikodukapatta, Andiravile, Apathe Edithu, Anaitu Valla Tande, Ubakunandri Selithi, Ade Pittu, Sidaku Koduttu, Ide Ivangi Unungal, Idu Ungalukaha, Alikapatta Ennudal, En ninaivaga idai seiyungal endrar. Elesinma prathri bhojana avasanedi midiyusha bandhuna gatun vahanse obaratu didimen pasuva mese pavasamin tama shravakayata dunseka oba silu denamen paane karanna sandahada mulu sri satavetada Paukamava Sandaha, Vagurana Naugyusu me, Mage Rudreya meyai, Obeya Panekana Samavitama, Masi Kirima Pinisa, Meya Siddhukarana. Great is the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and you will live by resurrection. We await your coming again.
The bread which we break, is it not a sharing in the body of Christ? Rejoicing in the presence of God here among us, we now pray.
The peace of the Lord be always with you. Devadana, Devadana.
Thank you. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lord.
Thank you.
Let's say the post-communion prayer together. Father of all, we thank you that you have shared this feast of your kingdom with all your peoples and have united all races in your Son, Jesus Christ. May the unity we have known here give us a joyful anticipation of the fullness of life to which you call us through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor everyone. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.